Hello children, welcome to our class of the continuation of magnetic effects of electric current in that solenoid. See, the solenoid, which is nothing but a type of electromagnet, the purpose of which is generate a controlled magnetic field through a coil wound in a tightly packed helix. See, the coil can be arranged to produce a uniform magnetic field in a volume of space when an electric current is passed through it. See, take a long wire and coil it like a spring. See, the turns of the spring should be closely spaced and insulated from each other. See, you can be wrapped the insulated copper wire over an insulated hollow cylindrical body, what we are seeing in that diagram. Okay, see, the next one is the magnetic field due to a current in a solenoid. It is magnetic field of a solenoid. See, from this explanation, what we know, a solenoid can be defined as a long coil of many circular turns of insulated metal wire wrapped closely in the shape of cylindrical. Right, such we have to take here, the length is very large as compared to the diameter. Right. Now, when the current is passed through such a solenoid, a magnetic field is produced around and within, that means inside the solenoid also. See, the end of the solenoid at which the current flows in anticlockwise directions behaves as a magnetic north pole. And the other end of the solenoid at which the current flows in clockwise direction, it behaves as the magnetic south pole. So we can conclude that the solenoid, which is produces a magnetic field in which the lines of forces are very much similar to the bar magnet. Okay, now why we need to know about the solenoid? Why that much? What is the importance in that? See, the diagram which we are seeing in that screen or different applications of the solenoid. So wherever we are applying the solenoids, in our day-to-day life we are applying the solenoids. The solenoid can be used to electrically open the doors and latches, open or close the valves, move and operate the robotic limbs and machinism, and even actuate electrical switches. Even that, then the car, when we are getting started, no? That I am getting the electrical spark, which is with the help of the solenoids, right? Now, the electrical uniform magnetic field. And what is non-uniform magnetic field? With the help of the field lines, we can understand the magnetic field lines which are uniform and non-uniform. By seeing the diagram, you people can understand that the magnetic field lines of forces are equal in magnitude and direction is same at every point in the space. So that we can call it as uniform magnetic field. The non-uniform magnetic field means what? That means the lines of forces are not equal in magnitude and the direction is also not same at every point in the same, right? This is nothing but the non-uniform magnetic field. How in the solenoid the magnetic field, which is the magnetic field inside the solenoid is uniform, but outside the magnetic field, that is non-uniform. The direction of the magnetic field lines inside the solenoid is, which is from south to north, and outside the solenoid, it is from north pole to south pole. Okay, suppose on reversing the direction of the current flowing through the solenoid, the north pole and the south pole get automatically interchanged. Okay, right. The next one is the direction of magnetic field. How the magnetic field lines and the direction we can see. See, the direction of the magnetic field produced by a solenoid can be determined by right hand thumb rule. What is right hand thumb rule? If we hold the solenoid in the right hand such that curl the fingers or in the direction of current. Then the thumb gives the direction of magnetic field, as we have already explained. So this will help to know the direction of magnetic field in the solenoid. Okay, the direction of magnetic field produced by a solenoid can be also be determined with the help of the bar magnet. How can we know the strength of the magnetic field? See, the strength of the magnetic field produced by a current carrying solenoid, which is depends on the two different factors. One is the number of turns which of the coil of the solenoid. The next one is the strength of the current. The strength of the current is flowing through it, and it can be found by the Clark's rule. Clark rule, which is nothing but with through the diagram which you are seeing it, the N and the S symbol you are seeing, no? The two, we can take it as the Clark rule symbols. See, if suppose the current flows around the end of the coil in anticlockwise direction, then the face of the coil behaves like the magnetic north pole. And if it flows in a clockwise direction, means what will happen? The face of the coil behaves like a magnetic south pole. Yes. Have you all understand, children? Yes. Thank you, children.